Right now I have my type sitting here. I have, if I go to outline view, everything is discrete shapes. Each one of these outlines is a shape of a color, which is good. And now I want to apply some trapping to it. And trapping is a process where you overlap one color underneath another color so that when it gets printed, the top color covers up any variation in registration from the previous colors. So if if the colors move around a little bit on the press during the print job, if you have a big thick outline, it can cover up any errors. And this is common in the world of silkscreen, which isn't as tight and precise as the bigger lithographic and digital presses. So we're going to do that. What we want to do first, though, is get this under control so it's easier to figure out. So I think what I'm going to do, instead of have everything in one layer, I'm going to make myself some new layers, and I will name them with the top color I want to print is the maroon. That's the darkest, most dense color that will cover other colors. So the maroon, I'm going to follow that with the green, and I'm going to have the last one be the blue. And the blue and the green are pretty much on the same level as far as a color that could be covered by another color. I'm talking about kind of the coloring value of colors. So here we go. I'm going to get in tight and look at this. See what I get when I use a selector tool. Move this over a bit. So I can see that I have the blue selected. And let's see if this works. If I go up here to the, move that to the blue. And that is my blue. Now if I select my maroon parts, according to the background or the fill color here, that should be the maroons. Move that there. Turn that off. And all that's left is the green. And I will move those to there. And I can turn those all on. Everything should be there. And this layer one, I will just get rid of. And since I'm going to be doing color separations and not worrying about the photograph anymore, I'm going to get rid of it too. So now I have just my three groups of shapes, the maroon, the green, and the blue. Excellent. It's worth pointing out here that as I'm going through these steps, I'm saving versions of my file so that if I have anything go wrong, I can go back and start over at any one point, which is a good practice whenever you're working on tricky projects. So what I want to do is I want to start by doing a trap on the green, which means it's going to go slightly underneath the maroon. And that gives me a little leeway when printing. I have the separations preview on. So right now, there should be no CMYK. So I turn that off and nothing happens. Good. There's my green, there's my maroon, and there's my blue. And they just all butt fit to each other. There's no overlap at all. So what I want to do with this is select my green, and I'm going to lock these guys off just for safety's sake. All I have to do with this green is apply a stroke to it. So I can go to my stroke controls here, and I could say I'm going to use a pretty big stroke. I'm going to use a 3-point stroke, which is unusually large. And over here I'm going to make it a green color. And right now we don't see anything. That's because our maroon here is knocking out the colors underneath, so nothing happens. But if I change this attribute to overprint fill on only the maroon, because it's the one that sits on top, it will print over overprint, it'll print over that green that I just added. So here's the trapping stroke for the green, and the maroon is overprinted. I've got three separate colors set up here, and this is the easy part. This is the green trapping is all taken care of, and what I have to do in the next episode is get into the trickier blue trapping.